In the last video, I talked about the 10 steps you need to take when implementing PIM. However, before implementing it, you should consider a pre-implementation analysis to ensure the project's success. Hi everyone, for those that don't know me yet, my name is Camilo, I'm a digital advisor at IDEO Software, and today I'll be speaking about the importance of conducting a comprehensive pre-implementation analysis. And I'll walk you through the questions you need to ask when implementing a PIM software. Let's start. The pre-implementation analysis is a set of activities performed at the IT project preparation stage. Its main objective is to translate business assumptions into technological ones. It is, therefore, a specification of all the work required to implement a given product successfully. As a result, the service provider clearly understands the client's expectations and knows how to meet them. Meanwhile, clients can be confident that the result will be exactly what they expected. Any activity, whether implementing or adapting an existing system, requires an analysis phase. Unfortunately, many business owners and service providers underestimate the importance of pre-implementation analysis. For clients, this is often an unnecessary activity that adds cost and little value to the project. Entrepreneurs often say, "I have chosen an experienced provider, so they should know how to do their job." I know from my experience that some projects have turned out to be impossible after a technological analysis. For example, problems with the old system or technical debt or insufficient budget for the implementation. This is why I believe that defining the project, its scope, success measures, and associated risk is crucial. After outlining what the project aims to achieve, we move on to the key analysis conducted when meeting the client. Business analysis can help answer questions such as, what are the company's bottlenecks? What does the business really need? Which processes need to be optimized and automated? What is the average time and cost of each project in the organization? What comes next? Stage 1. Product offer structure. To start analyzing needs, it is necessary to define the structure of the customer's product offering to know how to introduce it into the PIM system. Here, you can determine which functions you need and which can be integrated in the future. Stage 2. Definition of requirements. This part is a presentation of the implementation concept, a complete description of the entire design system. It includes functional requirements, which define and describe all the functions that the system should provide and how the system should act in specific situations. The purpose of this section is to describe the system's general vision and the objective it intends to achieve, and how it will be created. Non-functional requirements. The limits and standards that the system should meet. This includes performance, availability, reliability, security, scalability, and regulatory issues. Stage 3. Description of modules and information architecture. At this stage, it is necessary to clarify the information from two points of view. System operation. Requirements in terms of efficiency, performance, reliability, and scalability of the system. Architecture for integration with other systems. Stage 4. Define the user's roles and the processes in the system. For e-commerce systems, defining users and their roles is critical. It makes it possible to understand and correctly describe the access path and the people using it. Strategy development is one of the most critical elements of a project implementation, and a well-prepared strategy will help you to be an effective participant in the pre-implementation analysis. This way, you can be sure that the service provider understands your business needs and can customize the PIM and its functionalities. In other words, a strategy is the middle ground between where you are and where you want to be. Your strategy should involve the entire team, including implementation experts. The strategies will vary depending on the objectives of the business. If you are a retailer, you want to create the best customer experience. And if you are a manufacturer, you want to provide the best data quality so that the retailer will not exclude you. Here are some of the steps you can take to develop a good PIM strategy. Identify the conditions and business environment. What is the purpose of implementing a PIM system? What problems is the PIM implementation supposed to solve? What do you expect from the implementation as a business? Develop organizational conditions. Ask yourself these questions. How do you see the cooperation with the provider? What is the budget? What are the criteria for selecting your PIM system? Clarified product information. How many products does your company have? What has the process of managing the product base been like so far? How many people have been involved in it? Into which systems do you want to import the product information from the PIM system? Identify data sources and migrations. Where do you currently store product information? What kind of data do you need to synchronize with the PIM system? During synchronization, is it possible for the product information from two different systems to overlap? In this case, which systems will have higher priority? For large and complex projects, it is a necessity and a standard practice to conduct a pre-implementation analysis. For simple projects, advice from IT experts and cross-company collaboration might be sufficient. However, it should be noted that this will never be a replacement for a professional pre-implementation analysis. So, it is worth counting on a good fortune in this aspect. A pre-implementation analysis is a kind of guarantee. It is crucial in any project, especially when implementing PIM. On the one hand, you can realistically shorten the time needed, find out actual costs, and obtain delivery guarantee from the service provider. On the other hand, the provider can plan the implementation according to how you want to work. As a result, the quality of the cooperation can be completely different. I hope you have found this material helpful for your own PIM project. At IDEO Software, we provide comprehensive support from needs analysis to systems implementation. If you want to know more about implementing PIM and conducting a pre-implementation analysis, look at our guidebook, How to Implement PIM, or reach out to me with any questions or concerns. Subscribe to our channel, hit the bell, and if you have already decided to implement a PIM solution, request your personalized free demo here.